fucking shot that cunt in the head though. He's dead. One more, maybe.
Another one.
Yeah. There you go, mate.
Fuck.
Get him?
There was fucking three of them. Yeah, they're dead. Is anyone else? Oh, of course.
We lost Lobby, no!
Yeah, he popped around.
Oh, there was fucking two of them there. See was him.
Oh, wow. My armor is cooked.
Well, hopefully the man has brought you some more armors.
I have a feeling his armor.
Oh, I'm dead.
From where?
Broken the fire. There's not even any fire in the room. You literally jump in.
I fucking murdered him.
Nice.
It's not going to be a popular opinion, all right, at all. But I honestly believe that they need to stop allowing you to put founded raid stuff inside your skill container. Like, just stop it entirely. Take stuff in.
Oh shit.
Holy fuck, dude.
I'm dead?
No!
You take so many shots, dude.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god, that cunt's gonna be so fucking mad. Bro, how mad are you? You are the most mad you've ever been in your life. No.
Dead.
Maybe there was a bot. Oh shit, there's a bloke over this side. Oh. No. Still those suppressed shots from somewhere.
Sorry, guys, pushing in. Yeah, guys running up the hill over that way. Probably shouldn't have shot, but.
Oh, watch your brain! Watch
your... Pull in.
Not blind, but he's ready.
good.
Oh my god, there's a fucking cunt right here. Oh, he's dead.
Did
he's
you
dead.
Kill him?
He's dead. He's a thick boy. I don't know where his friend. I don't know if he's got any friends.
Is he the friend?
I kind of have no idea.
Deeria points, so like excellent work by Miro here, being able to hold off three players inside Foundation. He'll just be really, really hoping that we can either wait for that timer to come down and hold off those players to be able to secure that GL and fire those six rounds. Really sort of leaning on teammate Arthur here, designated marksman for Team China, to hopefully be able to take down one of these players.
Listen, I'm gonna be real with you guys.
Looks like he has been able to take
time.
Down one of
I understand
Thailand,
you were
so
first.
Now a 2v2 round.
In the chat,
Arthur moving off the train lines.
But actually, streamer is always
here.
First.
Time is ticking down. We're now less.
Just
than
putting
two
that out there.
The
time. How you doing, son? How you doing, Apple? Hello, hello, hello.
Arthur with the grenades here. Miro in a fight with two players upstairs. Manages to take down the remaining two players for Team Thailand, and that is going to be a win for Team China in round 4. Of the final set. So that is 3 wins for Team China. Absolutely insane plays by Miru there, just getting those lined up.
Oh, fuck off.
Hey, yesing people on Factory. I love it. I love it. I love it. Big fan of the old KS. I don't get to use it that often, and I don't use it that often. Mainly because every time somebody shoots me with a fucking KS, dead, insta, flashed, blind. Every time I shoot somebody with a KS, it doesn't work. So, big fan of it in theory. I think it's definitely a gun to keep your eyes on, keep an eye out for. But yeah, definitely feel the pain of that shit never working when I need it to work. Been practicing Dill Hero Streets loot run on my scav, and man, people miss a lot of stuff. Look, new map, I think people are going to miss a lot of stuff, lots of new players. Like, I just think we're going to have a lot of people that are just missing a lot of stuff, regardless, you know? Look at that, guys. We're level 2 intel. This is so good. Hey, what's one of these worth? Oh, you can't buy them. Okay. Oh, Bitcoin! We can do Bitcoin, guys. Let's do it. Let's grab some stuff. Let's do some Bitcoins, huh? Gamba case. Gamba. Yes. Very excited about this, too. All right, let's get all of this shit, too, so we can do Gamba. Let's make a one raid. I had 2 Tetris, a lion, a cock, a GPU. Got shot in the back by a duo player scav team, and after killing one and escaping, I ran into a duo PMC team, killed one, and then died. That is an event, a very eventful day. I didn't even get to change any of my hideout stuff this morning. Sag. It's been a busy day for me too. I spent most of the day out of the house. It was fantastic. Hung out with the wife and child. It was a good day. While running at 30 FPS. Well, I mean, you know what they say. If you can kill somebody at 30 FPS, you can probably kill somebody at 60 FPS. Big true. All right, give me those things. What do we got? I think everything else is... I think I'm cock-blocked on everything else, so that's fine. Find a transfer for MOE micro rigs. That's fine. Scavs from a distance of more than 20 meters. Yeah, we'll probably get that done tonight. That'll be fine. Exit location reserve. Not interested. Cool. Let's go for a quick run to Interchange. Go and get some of those tech items we need, and we're good. Green Aardvark, yeah, playing at 30 is damn hard. So, I was a little bit late to this wipe, and while I was away, I was playing... The only laptop I had with me was a laptop that had a decent i7 in it, right? 11th gen, 1135, yeah. Not bad i7. However, what I didn't have was a GPU. So I played Tarkov. I did some scav runs. I didn't do any PMC runs while I was away, but I did some scav runs. Initially with everything on low, still in native resolution, so 1920, 1080, everything on low, all shadows turned off, all that sort of shit. I was getting about 14 frames a second. Not ideal. And then I turned FSR 2.1 on, right? And I was getting 45 frames a second, and it felt buttery smooth. However, obviously, FSR, the way it was, everything was just, like, was blurry, right? It wasn't good. But I managed to fill nearly two junk boxes, was able to buy my second junk box, and was in a really good position based purely off scab runs for the start of my wipe, which meant I had a little bit of cash there, I had some of the items I needed for, you know, hideout stuff to build and all of that. So it was good. Like, I'm happy I did it. There was also the potential that I had to do a drop stream while I was away on that system. So, thankfully I didn't in the end. But I was prepared. I was prepared. Afraid was supposed to be here an hour ago and he's still not here. Yeah, I don't know where he is. I'd sent him DMs a while ago and he hasn't responded. I think he's busy doing something else. I think he's found new friends, Apple. He doesn't want to talk to us anymore. It's fine. We won't forget him. We won't forget him. FSR 2.1. Yeah, FSR will still work. Dude, it will work with your 1070. No, I wouldn't necessarily recommend it. You could try it. Use the newer version of FSR, and you could have it, like, on quality or something like that. What it does is it improves the general feel of the game, but like you're missing a lot of information in there, right? Like it's not good. It's really not good. I'll try and pull up some screenshots afterwards. I took a couple of screenshots of what it looked like, and it was not ideal. But it got me through a tough time, guys. So it's all good. Had the same experience with Darktide Aardvark. Oof. Yeah, it's a rough time. But you know what? If you need to do some hideout stuff, you need to do some scav runs, like, it's all fairly low-risk stuff. Like, I didn't really care if I died. And quite frankly, I did die a couple of times just because I couldn't fucking see anything. I'm getting shot by a blurry mass in the middle of my screen. Trying to aim for muzzle flash that was just, like, my whole screen was white. So, you know. It's the beauty of scavs, right? Scavs, 2 OP confirmed. Nerf scavs. Nerf scavs. We should check TTS, because a lot of this hasn't been done. We'll have a look, and then we'll go back to the PCs. I need GPUs and shit. Just traded a purple labs card for a red rebel. Ooh, Hey, bro, what's up? I think for the most part, that's a decent trade if you don't plan on going to labs. Especially early on. If you do a lot more reserve, man, I think that's a really solid play, to be honest. Personally, I would have sold it on the flea. For rubles. Personally. But I just want that spicy flea rep, yo. Like, I just give me my flea rep. You know what I'm saying? Can you look up on your scav as far as it can go? I can definitely. It does not go past 90 degrees. Yours did on streets. Huh? I think bartering on flea does give rep. But it doesn't work out the same to the cash value, right? Like, I think it works off trader values and stuff. Crit, hello, mate. How much do I list green for so I can afford kits after dying to people who don't use their keyboard in Resort? I reckon you can still list it for a bit. Like, I honestly reckon you could probably list green for like 12 million rubles. I don't know what the fee on that is. Also, there's probably going to be somebody like there to buy it. Maybe at this point in wipe. Like, I think you're probably at a point where somebody's going to have some money. 12 million. 12 million, I would say. Like around that sort of mark. Or you could get 10 million for it or 8 million for it. Like, it's really hard to know. I haven't seen any listed for cash. What I definitely would do, like, yeah, the waiting for at least Intelligence Center 2 in your hideout would be the go because of the ridiculous fees you'll pay. You have to? Perfect. Yeah, like, what's the fee if you put it up for, like, 8 mil? Because it's hard to find. I think you will have somebody buy it. It can only be found in raid. It's incredibly rare to find. Most people go their entire wipe or careers in Tarkov without ever seeing one in the wild. Like, it's not out of the question to say, hey, well, it's probably worth a bit. And it's not hard to get rubles. And if somebody really wants it, they'll just get the money, right? A 2.7 fee. Okay, That's not bad. Okay, so you'd net 5 mil. You'd net 5 mil. Maybe 2? Maybe 2 mil? Oh, sorry, maybe 12 mil? Like, see what that is? You probably will cash some more, but the question then is what's it actually gonna sell for? TC lad, how are you, man? What's going on? I hope you're well, sir. I hope you're very well. Not going to labs? Yeah, true. Jib, how are you, mates? Sorry, I'm not going to labs until they make labs free. I'm going to stockpile my 30 fucking labs cards like I did last wipe. And I'm going to just neglect to use them until they're worthless. And then I'll consider using them. Absolute 500 IQ move. Just like I did last wipe. I really should have used them, man. I should have been taking more advantage of labs. I have to go to the labs to get a damn GPS unit thing. Yeah, it's true. Like, do they only spawn on labs? I haven't even looked that up yet. Is this only a labs thing? Went labs 4 times last wipe. I went a few times last wipe. Like, I had a great time on labs the times that I went. I just didn't go often. Because I had just had TAS. I had fucking TAS all wipe. Another drill? I can't fit it. Yeah, I just had tasks all wipe, so I really didn't focus on it, because I was just, you know, took me all wipe to get Kappa. What's this? Swordens. We love swordens, and we'll eat the food. Labs. Think you can craft it, though, later? Okay. Well, I'll go to labs and I'll find it there. I don't think it's on the flea or it can't be fleed, so at least, you know, at least that's good. This is the morning. Oh no, afternoon. I would have gone afternoon. It's like a. I went in at like 1700, I guess. When you last played, yeah. I couldn't tell you, Crit, to be honest. I'm a really bad indicator. If I played on a different account, maybe. But I'm a really bad indicator, honestly, of being like, ooh, of what is good or bad for cheater rates. Because I've played coming up to 80 raids, 90 raids, and again, this isn't, I'm not trying to flex, this isn't a, yeah, like 80 or 90 raids, I haven't yet had any blatant cheaters, maybe one. Like, it's, I think they can see my name. I think the issue is they can see my name, and they go, nope, we're not fucking with that. I think that's all it comes down to. Yeah, oh no, I know you have. You've had a really fucking rough time. Oh, Milosh, how are you, mate? Look, it's all good. It's the Milosh, same treatment we provide to anyone. If somebody thinks they've been false banned, there are absolutely avenues to go through. This is obviously something that escalated pretty quickly on social media. And I didn't even get the opportunity to reach out to the guy. Somebody just said, hey, speak to Trent, he might be able to help. And look, all I've done, Milosh, is simply just make sure that that's had some visibility in front of the CM teams. And it'll get assessed by a BSG. And if the dude's not cheating, he'll be unbanned. If the dude was cheating for some reason, or there was RMT involved, or there was some other flag somewhere on his account that said, yeah, he's a shitbag, then he won't be unbanned. It's all pretty above board and simple. Only one today? Okay. Look, and again, that's it. Like, I play majority of my playtime on the weekends, Crit. Like, so, it's hard. Streamers shouldn't be doing more than sending a clip. Well, and they don't, Crit. Like, that's... They don't at all. And in this case, it was nothing more than sending a clip. Oh, you found my stream from... Oh, thanks, Green Outback. Appreciate it. Yeah, look, I'm just a middleman here, guys. I wish there was some better results sometimes. Look, I know they have good intentions, and I know a lot of the team there pretty personally. I know they do work quite hard. I can't answer for the be-all and everything, though, unfortunately. Yeah, I don't want to sort of dwell on it too long, because it'll get sorted as it needs to be, but yeah, the only bit of knowledge that I can impart on you guys is that Reng doesn't have the ability to ban cheaters. He just simply doesn't have it. He does have, as a Sherpa, some additional ability to be able to forward some really obvious clips through of cheaters, and for them to be manually reviewed, right? Outside of a in-game report, it's something that, you know, realistically, anyone in the community has that ability via their regional emissary. Like, if you guys have clips of really fucking blatant shit flying, like crazy, crazy blatant stuff, send it through to me. I'm happy to receive it. I'll forward it on, we'll get it to the right people, and we'll make sure that, you know, bans happen when they need to happen, right? Like, it's not out of the question. I'll happily ask for those clips, and we can get them sent off. Really blatant stuff, though, is generally the easy stuff we'll have for manuals. Things outside of that, it's hard. There's a lot more info without things like logs. There is zero fucking way that this is here still at this time in this fucking raid. There is zero fuck... Chat. Please. Please, chat. What? We have to get out. We have to get out. There is no fucking way. How has that been there the whole raid? Ain't nobody touched it. Fucking hell. Yeah, okay. So what I was saying, we still need to get out yet, guys. We still need to get out. Just chill. We could get fucking smashed by somebody at the extract. What was I saying? Stream servers confirmed? Yeah, I wish. Yeah, so it's, look, whatever's happened, it obviously got passed up the chain. Maybe it was reviewed and that's what it thought it was. Maybe it wasn't properly reviewed. Or, you know, whatever reason, maybe it was just a ban put in place with a review later. I don't know. I don't know the procedure for manual clips. Once they leave my hands and go with an appropriate BSG team member, it's out of my hands and out of my control. So Oh, definitely not a great time for drama. And yeah, look, and this is part of what the emissary program's about, right? Like, if that dude had that happen and he reached out to one of the emissaries, this is why we try and create additional visibility for emissaries and things like that. He would have thought, cool, I've got this dude I can reach out to, and he will in future. If he ever has any problems, if you guys have any problems, you can reach out to me. I'll put you in contact with the right people. You know, and we can get those sort of things happening. Like, that's never an issue. That's what emissaries are there for, where we are your representatives in your region, right? That's literally what we do. Now, that dude, he's not from my region, but it was something that, you know, got posted in our regional Discord this morning. I was like, yep, cool. Can somebody send me the details of what this story's about and the background and blah, blah, blah. We had a look. And then, yeah, I got in touch with the guy got in touch with me, and we were able to sort it. So it was good. Holy fuck. Okay, well, that was a good raid, guys. Jesus Christ. As if we find analytics there. Anyway. Time to end stream? Yeah, I mean, that's a good haul. I had to quit a wipe because my gamma got yeeted the same as Pestilius during the server instability 2 wipes ago. Look, this is, you know, like, for the most part, Aardvark. Seth, that was in the box at the escalator. That was in the box at the escalator, below Techlight, just out the front of Texco. 8 minutes left in raid. Still sitting there in the box. Nobody checked. The rumors are definitely true. Yeah, so this isn't just for big boy stuff. Like, if you're getting nowhere with support, things like that, you're welcome to reach out with us. We are limited in our ability as to what we can do sometimes. Like, for technical instability stuff, like, it's fucked, right? Like, I get it. You know, obviously, you know, maybe it was no fault of your own. I have no idea. I know support gets slammed nonstop with shit. So yeah, I can't comment on this. This was Inti. Hello, Lion. The box, the crate out, near the escalator out the front of Texco. Yeah, so I can't comment specifically on those things because I don't fucking know. But yeah, absolutely. Like, if there's problems, if there's issues, you can always reach out to us. And the worst thing we can ever say is, I can't help you, you know? Like, because I'm sure one of the responses as well, Aardvark, would have been, hey, just reset your account and you'll get Gamma back, right? Which, you know, partway through a wipe, I'm not going to lie, man. If that happened to me, I'd be fucking mad as hell. If that happened to me, I'd be mad as hell. Because I'd put shitloads of stuff in as a pain in the ass. And yeah, and I think honestly, Aardvark, like, there's a couple of reasons for that I can think of. One, they don't really have an easy technical way of doing it, right? Like, maybe there's just no super easy technical way of doing it, and it happened to such a limited number of people that it's just a fucking inconceivable thing for a game that's in active development, right? Not ideal, certainly, for you as a customer and somebody who's participating in you know, what they will describe as a beta game, of which it is. They literally gave Pestilius Gamma immediately. Yeah, look. Yeah, that side of it, I agree, that's fucked. Pest deleting his Gamma, I'm glad he did. Pest's a good guy. Like, done a lot for the community. Totally fine with that. Yeah, for that happening, yeah, it's kind of fucked. If you do it for one, you should do it for all. Again, I can't comment on it. But yeah. Tarkov has its own anti-cheat, right? No, well, Tarkov uses Battle Eye for its anti-cheat. Because you guys have thousands of people watching you. I'll tell you right now, Aardvark, there is like maybe four streamers that I could think of off the top of my head that would get that treatment. Like, four. maybe four. If you're lucky, four. And they're probably, it's less than you thought. It seriously is not a thing that's just an everyday, oh, they're a streamer, let's just give them the fucking priority because, you know, they're advertising the game or whatever. No, it's literally like four people. And I can tell you right now, us as emissaries would not get that same treatment in terms of if something missed. Yeah. Look, at the end of the day, the number of viewers has a small part to do with it, and it's probably what led to that in the beginning, right? Pester's got a lot of viewers. It's easy to make that assumption and say, well, Pester's got a lot of viewers, he gets special treatment. Pest has a lot of viewers, which led him to be way more involved with BSG, which led him to having a personal relationship with the fucking owner of the company. Right? Like, lost it during 80k viewers? Oh, I'm not aware of that, but he has a personal relationship with Nikita. There's a few streamers that do. Some who have actually worked for BSG previously and things like that. So, would I expect them to get special treatment? Yeah, probably. Is it unfair to all the other players who don't get the special treatment? Yeah, of course. But if I'm being fairly realistic, I think in most facets of our lives, we're always going to come up against shit where somebody's got a mate, somebody knows somebody. It's just one of those things. I think it's just part of life these days. Life's unfair. Yeah, it sucks. But yeah, I can tell you right now, for the most part, for the majority of people, they would not have got a gamma back at all. And the big part of that as well, Aardvark, a huge part of that, dude, is can you imagine how many fucking support tickets come through where people are like, bro, my gamma got deleted. My bitbox fucked up and it deleted my gamma. I need my gamma back. Or this happened, or that happened, or this happened. Like, the number of tickets that come through being like, oh, the game bugged out, but I was hitting delete on one item, and then, like, because it froze, I selected my gamma, and then I was going to delete my gamma, and do you know what I mean? Epsilon with no case. That's crazy, bro. That's crazy. So, yeah, like, I get it. Completely unfair. I'm with you on that. And I, trust me, if it happened to me, I'd be fucking furious. I'd especially be furious when they said, no, Trent, you can't have another gamma case because of a bug in our game. I've also got a history in development, so I'm also very sympathetic for a developer that's like, yeah, look, we had a bug happen. It sucks. The game's in active development. We're sorry, but these are the things that you sign up for. These are the things you can expect, blah, blah, blah. So, yeah. Anyway, enough of me waffling on there about that sort of stuff. Chat, we got a fucking Ledex. Taste Bad, how are you, mate? I hope you're really good. Are you going to play a real game? Sir, this is most definitely a real game. I hope you're well, Taste Bad. I hope your weekend's going good, man. I bet the person who fixed it was watching Pestily at the time too. Potentially. I mean, Bray, Pest had his face in the game. You remember that time? You remember that time when Pest was doing the therapist cosplay, right? And they put Pest's face in the game? Like, you know? So, yeah. The man's gonna get some special treatment, alright? Like, I'm an emissary. I have an NDA with BSG. Right? I've signed my life away with them. There's still things I'm sure I don't find out. I'm sure there's things that the community managers don't find out sometimes. The Pest is like, hey, Nikita, bro, like, blah, 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 blah. And Nikita's like, well, you know, did the guy have 150k viewers last week? I mean, maybe. Pest is always significant viewers. Time to buy stocks in Tarkov? I don't know. I don't think they're a publicly traded company, so I don't think you can. I don't know. Anyway, we need to go and do some stuff, chat. We need to go and get some tasks done. Tarky Shooter. I need colleagues. I need markers and shit. And I think I need to go and do the jammers on Shoreline. And I need to do a bit of stuff here. We need GPUs still. We found a Ledex, so that was cool. But I also think maybe we should just punch through some of these therapist tasks. Because oh, I need to do disease history. Cringy's not on. He's got the keys. Oh, it's just ambulances. Let's do healthcare. Let's do healthcare privacy part one. Well, because I really haven't been looking for the GPUs. The problem. I really haven't been looking. I just haven't spent the time looking. Oh man, drills are worth fuck all now. I prioritized these over so much stuff. These were like 80k yesterday. Hello? Scammed. Alright, let's put the... No, we're going to keep the jammers out. We're going to chuck that on. We're going to repair it up. We're going to grab our handy-dandy Mosin. Bit of a headset. We're not going to worry about a helmet. We are going to take a Momex, though. And... yep, that'll do. Let's take some markers. 4, 5, 6... We'll take some additional markers for ambulances, and we'll just mark anything along the way and jam anything that we can. I think that is definitely the go. Let's grab a couple of grenades. A grenade. One grenade will do. Don't want to spend all the money. We really only got 87k right now, so... we're good there. We don't need any of that. We'll take a bag. That'll do there. And let's sell this one. It's like a 150k kit. Lion, I know, right? It's fucked. Sinful. How are you, man? What's going on? Sinful, thank you very much for the 2 years. Chat, 2 years of subscription. That man has come back and put up with a fairly non-existent streamer schedule, even though I keep promising a schedule at some point. Really, really up and down gameplay. And he keeps coming back. That's great. We love it. Sinful, thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Chat, we're going to load into this raid. I'll be back in 2 seconds. I do need to wee. Sinful, we found a Ledex. We found a Ledex, and we found it. I'll have to clip it out later. We found it in the box, the crate, at the bottom of the escalator, right at the front of Texco. Why are you so poor? Well, I'm not really too poor. I got 32.5 million stash foul, but I started Med 3 the other day, Lion. So I had like 2 million rubles, and there's two things I did pretty quickly in succession, or I had a little bit more than 2 million. I bought a scav junk box. I then immediately, I can't show you, but I then immediately bought an opthal, a Ledex, and paid the 500k fee to do Med 3. So I got Med 3 up, but obviously, yeah, that was fucking pricey, man. Haven't played much before because of work. That sucks, man. Well, hopefully you'll get some more time to play soon, dude. All right, chat. I'll be back in a second. Still locked out on hideout because I'm trying to only quest for static. Fair. I like that. All right, I'll be back in 2 seconds, guys. I won't be long. We'll load into this raid.
Okay. That's why I feel bad that I stole it.
No. I did say it. I said both of us just go for him, and I took a spray at him.
I'm dead. Someone just walked in behind us from West Door.
Huh?
Where are you, Trent? Oh, that's Trent.
Me. Stop. I killed him. He's dead.
I killed the other. Nice.
What the fuck? All the right things, but don't know how to show it. The stars
align when it's just right. So we can take the long road. Just don't know where it's going. And even if it's not right now.
saw one go in. I haven't seen the second go in. In between the truck and the tent.
He's up on the back hill near the tents he was. Wannum's got a heavy bleed out here. Obviously got shot by the scav. He's in the extract now. Oh my god. Oh, he's well dead.
Nice.
I'm not even kidding.
Good luck, boys.
Where is he?
He's like right behind the counter. Oh, that was fucking terrible. Hang on.
You did? Okay, afraid, but it's like sit in a bush while you deal with
foreign
diplomacy.
Oh, I just grenaded him in one shot. Let's go.
You good? You
hey,
good?
Hey, nice.
He's dead. He's, dead. He's
I'm
dead.
Alright, Trent, you need to get the helmet and dip.
Alright, I'm back. Sorry. Been drinking lots of water today. It's been hot as fuck here today, and I've been drinking so much water, which subsequently means lots of toilet breaks. The drama once again, it's just Reddit Witch Hunt stream did nothing wrong. Yeah, it's look, the one thing I will say, Crit, is that probably sitting there and boasting I'll get you banned in 10 minutes, I probably wouldn't have said that, because it just Frank, oh my fucking god, chat, I didn't bring any ammo, chat, what's wrong with me? I have one grenade. Fuck! Is there a stash here somewhere? Can I get a gun? That I can shoot with? It doesn't even have any bullets! And a dream, it's true. Saying, there's definitely gonna be a lot of fucking dreaming going on here soon. Oh my god, I can't believe I have fucked that up. We waited all that time to load into a raid, and man doesn't even bring a fucking gun. Hello? Well, doesn't even bring any ammo for the gun. Knife check? I don't bring knives, dude, in case I find something. Yeah, I know there's a stash here somewhere, son, but I never can remember where it is. In between the bushes? Oh my god, my man, let's go. Please, gun. Please, gun. Please, gun. That's, none of this is a gun. That's not ammo either. It's a beanie. What the fuck am I gonna do with that? Shit. Check the house on the hill. Weapon crate. True. Don't need a gun on this map. It's alright. Yeah, well, I mean, if I'm not a threat, I won't be targeted, right? Yeah, no, I have, like, no ammo. Like, I've got, like, nothing. I loaded in with a Mosin with no bullets and went, I'll reload when I get into the raid because then I can, you know, then I can get those extra sniper skills, and my dumb ass didn't bring a single fuck of bullet into this whole goddamn raid. It was definitely hot today, chat. My brain was quite clearly cooked out in the heat. Should be able to bonk people with it? That's what I reckon. Grab it by the muzzle and just swing it around. I would at some stage like for them to include, if you don't have a melee weapon, hitting the melee button would do a melee attack with your weapon. I would really like to see that. Oh god, please have something. Like, just anything. A fucking pistol, bro. Shit. Or with your fists. Yeah, right? Well, we're bone chat. Okay. Just YOLO resort. Well, I do just... No, I reckon we can... I don't know. Ammo funds. Seth, thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Like, even if I can get a PM pistol out of this duffel bag down here, maybe? This is really not in a good way. I'm not gonna lie, my plan was certainly not to... I was happy to yeet this raid, but I certainly wasn't ready to zero to hero it. There's a stash near you? Like, around this somewhere? The base of the rock somewhere, maybe? Stash back up between the rocks and the house somewhere, I think. Oh, okay. Let's have a look. Next to house. Okay. Good advice, good advice. Sorry, I don't know my shoreline stashes, guys. I play this map to do the tasks, and then I don't ever really come back. Too many bushes. Oh, I'll be able to get to path the lighthouse, except for the fact that there's sniper scavs there. So I'm sort of... My thought process here, chat, was let's go and have a look for some ammo or a gun, because then at least... Only other stash is up against resort on the outside fence. Oh, okay. So there's one at this house or not? That's all right. If there's not one here, it's fine. We'll go hit the duffel bag. But yeah, my intention was hopefully we can just bide some time and maybe somebody will kill the sniper scavs up there and then we can just yeet for path to the lighthouse. One at power tower. There is, and I'm very cautious about going out that way because of... PMC spawns out that way, shooter spawns, all that rubbish. Yeah, there is a duffel here somewhere. There it is. PM pistol, gimme. Whip! Scavs can't shoot anyway. Yeah, I know. But I've got my... Lion, I've got my 70k armor on right now. I got my Mosin. We just said this is a 150k ruble kit. It's literally twice the amount of money I have. I don't know if we're really in a good financial position to just be yeeting in front of guns and ammo. Found. I think that was the one we just hit there, yeah? One can hope. Look, there's a weapon crate up the end here. I'm gonna try and hit that. If we can find a dead scav somewhere, that puts us in a way better position. I think we're good to make this pathing here. Please don't see me and shoot me. Please don't see me and shoot me. He's going the other way. This is good. This is good. We can get around him, chat. Potentially. It's zero. There's nothing in there. We're just going to have to be ready to VoIP if we, if we're really fucked here. If I find a dead scav, we can take his gun and I'm ready to rock. VoIP at the scav. No, we're not VoIPing at the scav. There is one left to the river. Yeah, that's right in front of those sniper scavs though. Remember those ones? Two we're trying to avoid. Scary. Too scary. The bunker has a crate. This is all terrible advice. Remember how I was like sniper scav? Just dodge them, you have healing? Yeah, but bro, like, huh? That's not gonna work if they headshot me. I don't have a helmet on. Yeah, we're just gonna go past. We're just gonna go past. In fact, tunnel is one of the extracts. So what I could do is we could make our way down to tunnel slowly, all right? We don't even have to extract, and we can go and put two of our markers on the ambos there, and then we just extract a tunnel. I think that's a good compromise. We still get something done, it's not a wasted raid, and I just have to be completely passive about it because I can't fucking shoot anything. It's endurance training, and I'm overweight too. Oh my god. Strength training. It's strength training, so that's fine. It's okay. See, this is what I was talking about. Check out room 306. Well, I mean, yeah, true, King Drizzle. But I ain't got the key. I mean, I do have the key. It's in my stash, but... No, I don't. I don't have 306. I got 219? 319? Something like that. I don't know. It was a good one. I know. Scav spawn a tunnel. I'm just... Again, I'm hoping they've been clapped there, and it's not a problem. Best case scenario, chat. We find a gun and we can continue the raid. Best case scenario. Worst case scenario, we die and somebody takes all my shit. Field cage too. Oh, I know, bro. I don't know where these are. We're just gonna run through. We're gonna mark the things. I'll tell you right now. The minute I stop moving with my head in the grass, trying to find stashes and shit everywhere that I really don't know if they're there. Like I'm dead. Is there weapon boxes in here? Swamp houses is good. At least I've got cover while I'm doing that. But yeah, this is what I was talking about before. I said Sinful Phoenix come back for two whole years of subscriptions, right? And Mance had to put up with me finding a LEDX in one raid and then just, like, being an idiot and not bringing any ammo for the next raid. Like, it's wild. Oh, good. Some ammo. Oh good. Some ammo. Unlucky. All right. The path to lighthouse bank near the truck. Okay. Just jam it in. It'll work. I mean, yeah, you think so. It's cool. We'll get through here. We'll get to tunnel. There'll be some dead scavs. Just to get to the stash in the middle. Dude, that's wild. Yeah, exactly. Does anyone know any static weapon spawns around here? Uh-oh, fuck. Okay, so some of the stuff you're saying here, chat, it's all really good advice, like in terms of location and where I could find weapons, things that'll help. And then some of the stuff, I'm not going to lie, these are dog shit suggestions because VoIPing to him would result in me dead. And I'm not about that life, you know? Oh, wow, some rubles. Oh, wow, a kite thing. Okay, now where... Was in one of these shops, did you say there's a weapon crate? Yeah, look, Hope, no ammo, bro. I fucked up. The left one, the wooden one. This one here, yeah? Is. Gimme. LPS. Fuck. Like, even just a PM pistol with, like, 4 rounds is enough. We can make that happen. Oh, wicked. Is there a duffel in here? There's jackets. That man must have just been in here. He's a shoreline enjoyer. Get in the tank. Fuck, that would be cool. Alright. Nothing here. Let's go tunnel. Hopefully that man went tunnel already and punched on there and killed scabs and I can just pick up a shitty scab gun. VPO or something. Incredible. Screws? I throw a packet of screws at somebody. One might get stuck in their eye. I win. Here, boat might be up. Well, I've got tunnel extract, so we can get out there. I'm also of a mind, though, chat. I'm also of a mind, if I'm being really honest here... We could just go and dump our armor and our gun in the water, okay? And continue this as a complete hatchling run to go and plant all the things. Like, what have we got to lose at this point? Because we might even just come across a dead scav, you know? And we have one grenade, so we could technically still get a kill. So that's not bad. I'm misbehaved. I'm not sure. I haven't had a chance to have a look at that yet myself. I don't think I've unlocked PC2 enough yet to see it. Probably worth more than that kit right now. Nah, that's fine. That's fine. You know what? You know what we do? Bam. Secured. Now we don't even need to extract. Okay, two ambos down. I think there's a weapon crate over in here. Oh my god, chat, look. Guns. We're saved. This is it. Grizzlies. And with these fucking rounds too. We have extra. I'll find LPS now. Oh, I'll almost guarantee I'll find some LPS now. Safe key, nice. All right, let's go. All right, grizzly slugs. Now we fucking gaming. All right. Let's sit in a bush here and work out where I'm going next. Oh, yeah, that's broken. Okay, third ambo. We just need to go up to resort for that one. Signal part three. So one of these is on top of resort. So we'll do ambo first, then we'll do signal. Oh, these trucks with the markers. Yeah, one of these is up at resort. So there's a few things we can mark at resort, which would be nice. There's also the bodies there as well. Okay. All right. Dev's trying not to run into you today, Miz. Nah, it's fine. I mean, I don't even bring ammo into raids. I'm literally harmless. Okay, so up to resort, I guess. Because, yeah, the raid time is ticking down, so this is actually quite good. Just need to not get shot. 10 rubles to a trader, yeah. I really do miss selling ammo. I used to craft so much ammo and sell it. It was one of the biggest things I'd craft constantly. I just fill my stockpiles up, and then when I had shitloads kicking around, I don't want to be inside this. And then when I had shitloads kicking around, I just sell the excess off. Easy. Yeah, it was way too easy to make money. Like, what about those scabs you'd kill with M855A1 or BP rounds from Raiders? Or if you came across, like, a bunch of M61 or M62, like, it was ridiculous. That was a nice little walkthrough shoreline, guys. It's chill. I like it. Yeah, I need to start crafting some AP20, actually. Scav. We're going to avoid... I don't know how good grizzly rounds are. I don't know how good I am with a scav fucking saga with grizzly rounds. Also, we have 10 rounds. It's fine. We keep moving. Lighthouse collection task tomorrow. Nice, nice. I think that's just a scav in there. Nope. Concern. More ammo, chat. That's good. More guns we can use. Oh shit, we need some food. Hey, appreciate it, Erina-chan, thanks. Oh, we definitely need some food now. Oh, we got food. Fuck yeah. That scav saved us so well. Kinky, what's going on, bro? We had food. It was fine. It was all good. Been sitting here selling stuff the entire time watching. Oh, dude. The initial grind. Sorry, because somebody was saying here earlier, was it actually 30 rep that you need to unlock your first slot on Flea? And I missed that message. I think we found the LEDX or something. But yes, it is. Guys, welcome for Preppy's chat. Hello, 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 hello. I hope you're all well. Preppy, thank you very much for the raid. I appreciate it. Going for cap of this wipe? I'm trying. I'm making it fucking hard on myself, though, I tell ya. My dumb ass came into this raid without any ammunition, for example. We had to find a dead scav before we could do anything. Big fan of making things stupidly hard on myself when it's just unnecessary. Fuck yeah, it was hot in Melbourne today. It was so hot. Oh, it was just so hot. We didn't search 5,000 crates. We searched a couple. There was definitely a lot more that people said we should do. Dylan, thank you very much, man. Appreciate the follow, guys. Yeah, Crit, I'm honestly the same. I do prefer Vaso than Golden Star. However, I've been smashing the Golden Stars so that I can get them down to one use and then I'll craft Propitols with them. If you're super prepared with them, they're good. If you're not super prepared with them, they're shit. Cult of the Lamb is addictive. Really, I haven't seen or heard anything until right exactly this moment now. I'll check it out. How addicting? How addicted are you? Hours the first day. Oof. Yo, I don't know that I've got that much time to I don't know that I've got that much time to play Vidges. Not on top of Taki. The Twitch interaction with the game is amazing. Really? Look, I'll trust you on that, and I'll definitely check it out. Is this the thing I need to mark? That's always shit to try and mark, like right out in the open here, where I'm definitely going to get fucking super blatted by scabs. Hello? Oh, I don't have any markers left. Yeah, it is, but it isn't. That's fine. We have jammers to put in place. We've come into this raid with an empty Mosin, no ammunition whatsoever, and we have zeroed to kind of mediocre manned our way all the way through this raid so far. We killed one scav, and we're gonna get two tasks done. I do. I got jammers. And I need to do those as well. I brought a whole bunch of markers, but I was kind of running out of room in my secure container. Yeah, level 100 sneak to hide from PMC. It's been wild. Chat, please go and check out Preppy Emote Siren if you haven't already. Amazing part of the Evasion family. One of the excellent senior battle mods, and also is part of the internal affairs team working on a bunch of amazing events and stuff and things, and all around just a really nice person. Please make sure give follow. Please make sure check out content. 42 hours in 3 days. Hello? I love it. Okay. All right. If that's not significant endorsement, I don't know what is at this point, you know? I got 14 minutes. Okay. The new offline stuff's gonna be pretty cool, Kinky. Honestly, if they keep going in that direction with it, gonna be very cool. It's like private servers, but we don't have to ring up BSG all the time when you wanna, you know, do shit. It's so good when you're trying to take care of chat as well. Wait, No, hang on. You had me at 42 hours, you had me at it's a really good game. I trust you a lot, Preppy, so you had me at... Hey, you should just check it out. You know? Like, that's a fairly general comment. And now you're telling me I have to actually take care of chat like they're some kind of fucking... Like, they're my responsibility? Hello? It's been a long day, but this raid's going good. This raid's actually going better than I think if I had have come in with ammunition. But Juice, I just, you know, you're all strapping young lads and lasses. Like, I don't know, man. Oh, okay. I'm back on board now, Preppy. That's cool. That's cool. I'm about that. All right. I'll check it out. Sacrifice is fun. I like that. And throw him in jail? Okay. All right. See, you should have led with that. If you led with that, I'm about it. Well, I think so, Kinky. Yeah, we're not sure if that's what's happened. There was either none or they've all left me alone. Look, we've even got armor now, Chad. This raid is wicked. I don't know how else I could make this raid, like, honestly go better than it already is. Okay, we have 11 minutes. We've placed all of our markers. Do I have time to run to resort, touch a bodies, run to cottage, touch a bodies, and then get to pier and touch a bodies? No. Maybe. I don't know, because I don't really even care if we die in this raid. Let's go. Ready for the icing on the cake? I'm ready. I'm ready. Got stims. I have a... whatever this is. Health regeneration. Energy recovery. Yeah, that's not going to help. I got no stims. We're fucked. Art style is amazing. Okay, I can get behind a really good art style. Like I said, I've heard nothing about it. Haven't seen anything about it. If I have enough energy, I'll be fine. Well, we picked up that extra food before, so I think we'll be good. Now there's like five frogs. What sort of frogs? I use a stim case full of morphine instead of, you know, yes. That's not a bad plan, actually. I got my stim case from one of the tasks, and then I sold it. Citing that I would get another one at a later stage, but just figured I'd sell it for, like, the 700 or 800k initially so that I could do hideout stuff, because I was already, like, a week late to wipe. And that's why I'm running the Golden Stars at the moment. I want those Propitols, man, to sell all those for the monies. Although I don't know if Propitol's going to go as hard this wipe. It's certainly not as useful. I think people will still use it for the heals, but... you know. Okay, we make it out of this raid, chat. If. Oh, not even... oh. I have to go here to cottage, back to pier, and then maybe we make it to tunnel. I make it out, I think... if pier is up. If pier is not up and we don't die to scabs, then I don't think we make it out of this, but we'll try. I'm willing to put in the effort for this, because if I can complete this task, I'd be very happy, and if we die, I don't care. I was already resigned to the fact we dumped all the good gear. We're already resigned to the fact that we're probably just gonna fucking die anyway, so it's fine. Like, is this the body here? That's the one. Yeah, look, 10 flea reps should be a slot. At least get me back to 3 slots. I'm pissed it isn't. Like, it is so fucking frustrating. Yeah, like, once you get that 3 slots, life's so much easier. If you can get to a 4th slot, perfect. I didn't get to unlock my 5th slot last wipe, because that was 150 flea rep, and I only got to 130. Oh, exhaustion debuff. True, Kinky, sorry. I'm just focusing on chat. How are we going energy-wise? Yeah, we're going to have to eat that. Wait, no. Stop. Cancel. Stop. Cancel. Stop. Cancel. We ate the food. Fuck. What I should have done was run out completely, then put my golden star on, then eaten the food. Maybe. Or maybe the food first was the plan, actually. Ragman quest should reward one slot. I think some quests open. Like, I would be happy with a quest giving you one extra slot. I think that would be good. I don't think that's unreasonable to do that. Chat, really starting to think there was only one dude in this raid, and he was the bloke who ran past me at the very beginning. It destroys it without using it all. Oh, man. So I shouldn't have cancelled. I shouldn't have freaked out. I should have just been chill and just let it do its thing. Excellent. Well, the good news is, guys, like, if we manage to get out of this raid, I'll be fairly impressed because I've done everything possible in the fucking textbook to fuck it up this raid. And we're still here. It's the scavs I'm worried about at this point, Lion. I have run around Shoreline twice. Yeah, we've been around the whole fucking map. I have done some kilometers. And we've got 6 minutes and we're massively draining energy. He does need a nap. He's pretty tired. Look, I'll give him a little break. Once we get out of here, we'll go on a scav run. We'll see if we can get another LEDX on our scav. And we'll give this guy a break. It's fine. He can have a rest. It's well earned at that point. God, I hope Pier's open. For two reasons. A, so that we can get out. But mainly B, which is... I fucking hate running around Shoreline, dude. Oh, it's because I'm just reading chat. I'm really not paying attention. And I'm not used to this much stam. Like, I just hold down shift and then I'm like, oh, that's right. I haven't got as much as endurance as I used to have. I'm definitely not tuned for being an early wipe Timmy, I'll tell you that right now. I'm gonna hit this stash down here and we'll see if we can get some food. Might have time to run. Look, we only need to run in, touch it, and get out. My concern is that we probably won't have time. Yeah, true. Oh, that's such a risk. That's such a risk. Can't even eat the fucking tea. What is this? Scammed. Any food left? Look at all this. Come on. Isn't there like a mouthful of some shit in one of these containers? That's my concern. I think the energy's gonna wreck me. We're at 10 now and we're about to run out of hydration. So what I should do now is let my stam bar get to full, so at least we've got some. I've got Golden Star, which will give us little itty-bitty bits, but it's not looking good. Alright, so we're dehydrated now. I'm not going to put on, and we got 5. Yep, good. Where are the bodies? Is that this one? It is. Crap. Oh, no, we might have... No, he's going to have 3 of those mags and a thing. That's all right, whatever. We'll just check for Pier. Hopefully Pier's up. Could always check the car boots on the way back if we need to. Please be up, please be up, please be up, please be up, please be up. Come on, give me the little green fucking marker. Come on, bro. It's not up, is it? Yes, it's up. We're so good. We're making a chat. We're getting out of this shit. Let's go. Oh, don't die from energy loss. We should be good. dies of exhaustion in the last second. I'm lining you up. Imagine. I wouldn't even be mad. That was such a free run. Like, I did not deserve to survive that at all. At all, I did not deserve to survive that. That's good. That's good. How, 7.197 kilometers. That's pretty impressive. That's pretty impressive. I'm alright with that result. You hit 10 flea rep, let's go! Your flea rep's way higher than me. I know, the fact that you achieved nothing sucks so much. It's calmed down a little bit, Squid. Like, it's 26 degrees here now, but it got to like 37 today. So it was warm. It was definitely warm. Search the room in the health resort for documents. More shoreline. Oh yeah, we can do this. I haven't got a cottage key, but we can do part of it. Signal part 3 finished is nice. Signal part 4 finished is nice. So good. He was asleep? Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, it was definitely warm here today. No doubt. Alright. Well, that was a pretty pog run. Let's sell this shit then. We'll keep the helmet. Oh, yeah, we'll sell the helmet. That can go. That can go. Ammos, we'll put you in here. Two slotter, tech one. BTs, we'll keep. Sure, we'll keep those as well. That can go there. Hey, Miz! Dude, thank you very much for the Prime Gaming, man. Appreciate it. Quests. Go there. One, two. Appreciate that, man. Thank you. And a safe key. Weather station safe key. You can go as well. Nice. All right. Heal. I need some food. Oh, what am I doing? Aqua. Aqua with a W. All right, metabolism up to 9. Winner, 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 winner. Crafted 450 AP20s. That's wicked. You'll probably actually need those, to be honest. Is Weather Station Key only 12,500 now? Interesting. Oh, because it's a brand new one. Nice. Benelli's worth. That's fine. We don't want that. There we go. They can go as well. Don't really care. Done. All right. 40 rounds. 20 odd rounds. Let's pop. This can all go back in here. We're going to grab a Mosin, right? Amazing, I know. We're going to grab a rig. I need some more markers. How many more markers do we need? We need one for the truck. I actually don't even want to take this. What I want to do is dump that out, and we want to grab a... I should have bought that for dollars. Oh well. One of those. I don't even want a Mosin actually. Pop these back. We need an AKM. Why is it half loaded? My Mosin? I don't know. I must have used it and come back and... Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Because we're going back to Shoreline, we should try and do the Punisher stuff. Let me buy the stuff, please. Yay, we got a gun. Some markers. We got no fucking money for markers now. I spent all my money on dumb stuffs. Boy, 43. Sold out for that. Nice. And then let's sell some diaries. Okay, I think we're good now. Once they sell, we'll have some cash. Thank you, Junie. Like six markers, I guess. Shit. I don't even know how many markers I need. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there, we've got emergency heals there, we're good, that's empty there, all our food's full, excellent. Swap hideout, go scav run, go back there, and we're all good. Ozmax, how are you, man? Trent was playing customs last night, unlocked 214, and safe was looted. Oh, like actual looted or just empty? Like door open looted? I don't know. Let's make one of these. Yeah, and that's all I do as well, Crit. Just literally just fucking flee everything. Oh, I can't afford another thing to make more wires. What we can do, though, is sell wires, actually. Oh, wait. God damn it, seriously? Hang on. I think we're good. Kate! Oh my god. Kate and Kate fam. Hello, guys. How are we all doing? Taki's good. Found a LEDX. Went to a map before. Didn't bring any ammo. spent 45 minutes on shoreline with no ammo. Got out, survived, completed 3 tasks. It was a good time. Taki is going great. How are you guys? What was on the agenda tonight? And swap this, I guess. More Bloodborne. Oh, very nice. All these people playing all these different games. And there's me here just grinding away at Taki. Another wipe after wipe. Will do, Ozmax, for sure. Oh, you sent through on Discord? Yeah, I will definitely do. Red, I don't know. I want to say it's worse because I couldn't even defend myself. Like, I'd definitely say it's worse. If I'm being really honest, yeah, I reckon it's not good. Heard some screams at one point. Oh my god! Beat a boss, then got bullied. That's rude. But Kate, thank you very much for the raid. I appreciate it. I hope everyone is doing good. Hopefully, it wasn't too hot for you guys over there. How warm did it get in Perth today? True, Sunchaser, very true. Biden, hello. 32 today? Oh, 32 is good. Yeah, we got hot in Melbourne today. It was like 37, I think. It's kind of crazy. It was a hot as fuck day. It was a good day, though. We went shopping. And, the shopping center was, like, nice and chill. It was good. I went out for fairly average Yum Cha. That was, like, $120 for lunch for 2 people. And my young child, who, you know what? She kind of just eats what we eat. So, you know, that was unexpected. I don't know what I expected. I didn't ask any prices. I didn't look at any menus. Well, I mean, I did. Well, not really. But, like, nothing's got prices on it. They just bring you a trolley and they go, here's some food. And you, in your head, you go, okay, surely that can't cost more than that. And then we left. And, yeah, it was $120. And I was like, okay. Probably would have made a bigger deal about going out for lunch if I knew I was spending $120. I didn't see your quail, no. We've got SS190s, SVD, this is such a good scav. And a big bag. Fuck, with heaps of time. Wouldn't eat anywhere if you couldn't see the prices. Look, that's kind of fair. And I don't know, I just figured... Restaurant, shopping center, like... Not fancy external deal, Yum Cha. I don't know what I was expecting, actually, in the end. All I know is that the shumai wasn't good enough to warrant $120 bill. At all. And the bean curd thing we got was pretty yuck. And the noodles were cold, so... You know, but... I don't know. And then they hit you with a 1.5% surcharge on card. It is what it is, chat. We're gonna go and just quickly check our crate here again, so we can find another lead X. Maybe we run upstairs and have a look. Maybe we don't. I don't know. And then we'll go and hit all the PC rooms. Oh, lead X! No. There was last raid. And it was good. Alright. Maybe somebody cleaned all this out this time. I don't know. Was defo worth 120? Mmm. That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Listen, I'm just glad Caitlin wasn't standing next to me when I was paying. She's like, I'll take Chase out here. And I'm like, alright, no worries. I'll fix up the bill. Then I paid. And I just walked out. And I said, hey, what'd you think? She goes, look, it was okay. She goes, I don't know if I'd eat there again in a hurry. But it was alright. I'm like, okay, cool. And then afterwards, later, she's like, she's just casually, because that was her choice. She wanted to go and do Yamcha today, and I just, no questions. Absolutely. Like, it is a rare opportunity that Caitlin says, oh, I want to eat there. Because normally it's whatever you want to do. And I go, okay, fair, fair. And then I'll go, but we'll do whatever you want to do. Like, I really don't care. I'm so unfussy about eating. And she's the one who's like, eh, maybe not that, or maybe not this, or blah, blah, blah. So anyway. Oh, Tetris, nice. So we did what she wanted to do today, and she put up no fuss about it. And I was really appreciative of that. So just, let's go. We're in. And, yeah, she did ask me later. She's like, oh, how much was lunch? I'm like, eh, let's not talk about it. And I was like, that's why I asked you if you enjoyed it or not. Because if you really enjoyed it, then the $120 was worth it. If you thought it was kind of like, yeah, whatever, then it was not worth so much. Hey, bro, what's up?
Not much, man. It's a fucking PMC out there.
Oh, is there? Oh, dude, I'm glad you got in. GG's. Is he chasing you, bro? Is he coming?
Yeah, he's out near the fucking highway chasing me down.
Nah, it's just two scabs, bro, coming. Oi, oi, oi.
Well, one of them shot.
Y'all friendly?
Damn, I'm really bad, eh?
Oh, I see. They were just fucking with this guy.
There's two of you.
That's sussy aim, bro. Are you guys scavs? Because if you're PMC, we can dip together.
No, we're scavs. We're scavs. Wee. We don't use that word. Come on, man. Come on. Jesus. All right. Gamer words. Hello, Jingly. What's going on? Look, that guy was obviously getting fucked with by those guys, and then he was... I don't know. I'm staying away from all of his shenanigans. More scavs in here? Dude, bro, everyone's fucked. Get out of my spots. It's all very scary. VoIP reporting him getting banned, zero tolerance. The problem is, I've walked away now, and I forgot to do that when I was there, and now I can't do that. But yes, I should have. New SSD POG, nice. But yeah, Crit, I don't mind paying $234 for dinner. I have no issues with that. Like, I'll pay good money for good dinner. But I want hot food. Good service. Decent shumai, like, you know, all of that shit. The stuff that comes with a decent bill for dinner. I'm alright with that. If it's a good time, a good experience, and good service, I'll easily drop $300 on dinner. It's fine. You pay lots for a whole experience. You really do. You really do. If I walk in and there's no one to greet me, and I just get, like, I just walk in and no one seats me at a table, there's no menu, there's no specials, there's no banter with any of the staff, like, there's just zero interaction. They want me to scan a QR code on a fucking table and just be about my way and then pay through that and then just have people who just literally come and put food on my table. Ain't no tips. It better cost fish and chip money. Next, you want to cook too? Yeah, look, sometimes. Not always, though. Not always. Yeah, if fancy dinner with Dashy was worth it, of course. That's wicked. 100% squid. 100%. Like I said, I didn't even bat an eyelid. It was totally fine. We got to pick something that she wanted to do today because she wanted to do it. And that's totally fine. It's all good. Most expensive meal I've had offered was $10,000 wines. Yeah, that's a bit, bit eggsy on the wines there, man. Jeez. I think once you get above maybe like $100 a bottle, like, I don't know that you could really tell if wine was like that good or not, you know? I couldn't. Some people can, maybe. Oh, 10,000 options. Look, yeah, well, they need to charge a lot for the meal then because they've got 10,000 bottles of fucking wine they need to store minimum. Over like $20 a bottle. I'm pretty well the same, Lion. $2 skinless. Yep, it's probably going to taste pretty trash. Something in that, like, you can get decent $20 bottles, like something in that $30, $40 range. Yeah, it's all, you know, it's all much of a muchness for me at that point. Definitely not a wine connoisseur of any kind, though. Starting to think I'm quicker to choose options than most women. Look, most of the time it's all good, Spork. Like, she's pretty good when picking options, but, like, if I give her two options, right? She's always forever just trying to please me and pick something because she is also fairly easy about what we eat. And then I get annoyed with it because I'm like, no, I want you to just pick something because you want to do it or because whatever. Like, we eat a lot of Asian food and I get worried and I'm like, well, does she really like Asian food or is she just eating the Asian food because I like it, you know? And maybe she likes it. Maybe she likes it a lot too. And she tells me she likes it a lot too. You know, maybe she just wants a pasta. Or a, I don't know, like anything. Anything else. I'm okay with that. But I don't know. Because she always goes, whatever you want. We'll eat wherever. Sounds a lot like bullying to me. It's definitely not a bully. Definitely not a bully. We've got 13 minutes in this raid. Are we going to get anything else achieved? Potentially. There was scary scavs kicking shit around, and there was lots of people that have been walking through the middle, so I think we leave. Yeah, pasta's a really good go-to meal, for sure. Coming to cook your own food again? Oh, true. Now, we're going to leave the other LEDXs for other people. Nick, I think. I got my one LEDX I need for my task. I think anything more than that is just greedy at this point. Butt spot? Hello? Don't fuck the air fuck. Solid advice. Yeah, air fryer's on our list of things we've been considering. Spidan for quite a while. It's just something I haven't done yet. I also want a decent rice cooker as well. Big fan of some well-cooked rice. Oh, did you have beans bot for a while? That's sick. I missed that. I missed that story arc in the critical stream. Now your brain is doing brain things. Did it work out? Like, move in month's budget is hard. It was forced upon him. Oh no. It changed itself back. Very good. Very good. Alright. We got some stuff. We got some stuff. Tech. Hello? Tech. Can't fit. Why can't I sort my... I can't sort the box. While I'm... Okay. This is not all going to fit anyway, I don't think. Let's put these in here. Come on, man. I've got a few of these. These can all go in here too. Yeah, we did it. Nice. Excellent. New junk box time? I've already got 5. I think I've got enough. The problem is I've got some space in some of those boxes that I just don't want to put. Like, I don't want to put the tech items in the quest items box if they don't need to go in there. You know, like, I've sort of using that hoarding box as an overflow box, but, like, I don't want tech items in a one or two or more slot box. Time for number 6. It's getting there. It is really getting there. Yeah, like, see, this box is mostly empty. And the tech box, very full. What are the power supplies worth at the moment? Okay. You organize this if the game doesn't autofill item fields anyway. We just like to keep things organized, alright. Oh, I need all these power supplies. I should keep them then. That's fine. Alright, chat. I'll load in here. I'll be back in 2 seconds. And, good luck to us on the shoreline. I'll be back in a sec. Won't be long.
This is alright, little Ash 12, little
NSS.
We
can have that Ash 12 if you want it.
Ooh! Get out!
Jesus.
Please.
Kids bogs. Bring bogs. Is it fun? Lick my paint, Rovers. Fuck me.
Oh my god. Petty heart, mate. Yeah, okay. Rich, burn. Oh my god, get out, get out, get out.
Bro, that's just toxic, bro. I was just trying to chill.
Amazing. I'm so dead here. No! I can't change my gun!
Is it worth flea rushing BTC? I don't know what you mean, Josh. What are you talking about? Yeah, it's pretty well what happens, Crit. It's gonna be a bonfire there for a few days, and then it'll settle down, and then there'll be something else that we'll yell about now. Which other streamers? Who else are we mad at on Reddit? What did you streamers do? What didn't we do, Morty? In all honesty? Just making shit up? Yeah. It's what happens. That's what happens. Streamers do nothing for this game, by the way, guys. All we do is ruin it for everybody. Oh fuck, I don't even know what that task was. Did I need a key for that task? 306? Yeah, well, fuck, I haven't got that. Have I? No. I can get some of these. And I can shoot scavs. And put the marker on the other truck. And get MRAs. Okay, let's go this way. I don't even know what I'm doing. Change the fire in a few days. Good call. How do you change the reticle? It's like an alt. Alt, right click or a control right click or something. I have it bound to one of my extra buttons on my mouse. Blash!
Not Oy. Hugely. Give me a sec.
I thought I was hearing sounds. It was in the clip. We probably just die here, by the way, chat. A man got Madge. Oh, it's more clip sounds. God, I think it's boiping in the game. God. Flash, I hope your stream was good, man. Hope you're well. This is so directional. It sounded like VoIP in the game. I got really confused. I don't know what was going on. And then I missed every shot on that guy. Because I'm wicked, by the way. Yeah, Alt R. Alt plus R click. Okay. Yeah, Alt plus right click. Yeah, that's the one. It's one of them. I knew it was somewhere there. I just couldn't remember.
Woo!
Really, just put it out there, guys. That helmet saved my fucking life. I don't know what he shot me with, but it was dog shit. Did not pen class 3 helmet. Raid's been good, man. Found a LEDX on Inti on my scav run. In the box, at the bottom of the escalators out the front of Texco, so that was... That was kind of wicked. So what have I even got all these markers here for anyway? I just bought a bunch of them, and I don't think... No. No, no, no. Hello? We should go and get his surgery kit. Kill some more scavs. Anesthesia? Oh, I only needed 2 markers in the end here anyway. Alright. Oh, really? Okay, I'll have to check it out, Kinky. We need to just chill here for a second and chuck the old, golden star on. What do you reckon? We'll go for a wander down to Pier. Oh, we're just going to wait here for a second because we've got a fucking contusion. Okay, we're good. Nice, we're all ready. We're all good. Eat like a fat kid of smorgies? Oh, bro. Smorgies. That takes me back, man. Oh. Wow. You know, I just feel like we were having a nice nostalgic moment there, and then you had to just go and call me, like, old. Look, I was like 11 when Smorgies disappeared from my area? 10? 10? I don't even know. Nah, ours got turned into a fucking bistro and pokies venue, so, I mean, I don't know what was worse. Food that might kill you, or shit that will literally kill your soul. And the innocence that remains of our older generations. That was a hot minute ago, yeah. Like, Josh, I don't know if you ever went to Smorgies. Dude! Fucking arm sway, are you kidding me? We do need to go up to Resort and mark some stuff there, too. Also, what is this dot on my screen? Is that from the... That's the stupid little sight on top, isn't it? It's this fucking thing. That does nothing, by the way. Maybe 18 years ago it went? Yeah, maybe? DRD armor. We'll take. East 107? I think that's a good key, isn't it? Yeah, Melbourne thing. Little bacon flavored chip things. Oh, like I don't even remember what I used to eat there. I think honestly I used to just hit like all the Asian stuff, just eat Tim Sims and all the fried shit. And then, of course, it was like just stack on with all of the amazing. I want to say, yeah, just all the amazing little fried things. That was pretty well it. That was pretty. That's a really good key. Fantastic. I'm stoked that we got that. Then it's exactly what we wanted. We needed a bit of a win tonight. It's been an average night, guys. Tonight, very average, clearly. Oh, cat. Oh, clock. And cat. We can fit both. Fantastic. No, it's been a good night. It's been a good night. There's slash S, guys. Come on. Is this the thing I gotta mark? Hello? What, do I gotta mark the bodies? Oh, I already did this one. We have to go to cottage. Oh, this is the thing, Biden. I used to smash, like, I used to eat heaps of it. So, near there, in the same area, there was one of the original, like, Pizza Hut restaurants, right? Yeah, I know, Blash, right? There was one of the original Pizza Hut restaurants, and it was an all-you-can-eat Pizza Hut. So, you'd go in, you could eat pizza, and I never used to eat the pizza. Never. I'd have, like, maybe one slice. All I'd do every time we went there was load the fuck up on all of the pasta, right? Carbonaras, you'd have some bolognese, like whatever was going on. I would just like pile plates up with pasta, 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 pasta. And then, yeah, it was jelly and ice cream. But I've never been much of a sweet tooth. So for me, like just being able to go to Pizza Hut and just like fucking eat a shitload of pasta was actually so good. Spagbog was a goat. That's it. That's it. Squid nose. Yeah, I was really young. I can't remember if the food was any good. Oh, really, Josh? Like, is it all you can eat again? I'll go. Random Dutch dude, these days, yes, I would absolutely be pizza over pasta. I don't know, back in the day, I just used to love the pasta. I don't know why. But I don't think I've gone to a pizza pasta or an Italian restaurant in a long time and actually ordered pasta in preference over pizza for, shit, probably 20 years. 15 years, something crazy like that. Oh, cool, can we go to Macca's now? That was your first takeaway you can recall? I mean, yeah. Trip to Ballarat, all you can eat. I mean, it's a fair journey. It's a fair journey. One left in Ballarat and that's it. I'm not against a day trip if they're open for lunch. Like, Jingly and I could catch a train into the city and then is it a V-line to Ballarat? Like, how do you get to Ballarat from Melbourne? Because I drive, but you know, we can't, yeah. Not allowed to drive at the moment, so. Worst pizza I've ever had is from Pizza Hut last year. I think they're more modern restaurants. Like, I think the pizza's shit. There's one product that's been on their menu for a long time that if I go there, I order, and it's because it's ridiculous. And because nowhere else does it, and it's still shit, but I still order it anyway. and I haven't ordered it in a long time, so I don't even know if they still do it. But it's the hot dog crust. Hot dog crust pizza, so good. Oh my god, this is open. We can get the thing we need. Cottage key. Which kind of means we need to leave. At tunnel. I'm gonna stop standing out there in the open for a second. Yeah, hot dog crust! They would put like hot dog, and then they'd like fold the crust around. Yeah, it's so good. It's like cheesy crust, but hot dog crust. That's long gone? Fuck! Okay, well, that just proves how long it's been since I've eaten there. I mean, if you really felt like some shitty hot dog sausage and pizza, it was the ultimate combination. It was so good. Oh, Mans didn't loot the jackets. Where is the jackets? There it is. The old Eagle Boys butcher block pizza. Oof, yeah, see, that'd be alright. That's one of the big square slabs, wasn't it? Oh, pinky fuck. Yeah, okay. See, like, yeah, if that had been an option, yeah, I probably would have ordered that. Oh, the duffel bag's in the other one. Okay. Hello. I am streamer. I know how to play this game. All right, let's get the fuck out of here. We got one task done. That's a pretty good win for me. Again, I guess. I'm so hungry now. I was not hungry after Yumcha lunch, so I only had like I just did like a coleslaw and barbecue chicken fresh sandwich for dinner. And Kane's like, "You sure that's all you want?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'm really not that hungry." And now that it's 1:15 in the morning and we've been talking about food, I am starving. I don't need to eat it this time, but still. There, food talk did not help. That's all right. That's all right. All scavs down here. Caution. Oh, there you are, mate. Oi, fuck off. I can't even see you, cunt. You seriously gonna do that? We're gonna play that game? And your friend? Oh, you're running around it. Hey, right. I see how it is. Now let's get the fuck out. We've got two scavs. That was a nice little bonus. With steak instead? Oh no. Maybe she did. I don't know. There was no rolls though, Josh. I was pissed. I really just wanted some barbecue chicken rolls tonight for dinner, and there was no rolls. So we had to use sandwich bread, which is fine. It's okay. He's snacking all day. Turkey's not bad. I rate turkey. $4 is good. That's so good. I don't know if it's on the same level as the Big Al's Nutella and Cheese Pizza though, Josh. I think Nutella Pizza's cool. I don't know about Nutella and Cheese. I think that's a bit, but. What did we even do? Oh, we did this one. Yes. Good. What else did we do? We didn't really complete anything else, though, because... yeah, we just didn't. All right. 107? 310k? Don't I have another 107 somewhere? No, I do not. I have 108. Right, which is worth absolutely nothing. It's completely dog shit. Very good. Oh, my hoarding box is full now as well. Fuck me. That's empty. Fill. $19. Top up. Eat some food. Drink some drinkage. Good. Yeah, price the whole thing. Smart, honestly. That's really smart. Okay, what am I still doing on Shoreline? I'm still doing Punisher Part 1. We have 5 more scavs for that. Let's definitely do it because I need this Sobralo. The one more marker, which is up at Resort. So a marker at Resort and I need 306. How much is 306? That's not terrible. We take that. It's one of the benefits of being late to wipe, I suppose. How the fuck do we get on without the junk box? Dusty's... I don't know. I've always been here for junk box. I've always been a junk box gang player. So I honestly, I couldn't tell you. That was before my time. I've only been playing 3 years. Alright, now what other shit have we got here? Oh, the fucking hoarding box is nearly full as well. God damn it. One of those. Did everything? Good. All right. All right. Quick scav run. Inti, we'll go get some PC parts. And I'll be back in 2 seconds, guys. I won't be long.
Six players killed. It's not bad. GG's, boy. This guy at all? I don't think we did. Hold on.
I might die here, but I'm gonna get them to stand still, okay?
Yeah, shootable and done, let's go, baby! He's stood there reloading or some shit. There's one more up still though. He's at the rocks.
I was running up and down the fucking up and down the staircase to one of the towers. They would have been trying to aim me up.
Well, can't he just stop there and he just
I'm back. Beardy, how are you, mate? What's going on? And Dueno, hello, sir. What's happening? Tell you what, I've had a lot of follows and stuff today due to that Reddit post. Across all things. I've even had people follow me on Reddit. I didn't realize people did that. Apart from stressing about the above. My laptop. Oh, rethermal paste laptop. Yeah, that's a bit stressful. Bit stressful. Reddit post. The TLDR. There was a guy that got banned. Whole drama about Rengor getting a manual ban done on him. Not quite the case. Blah blah blah. Anyway, I've spoken to the guy. We're sorting it out with BSG. Like, All I did was forward his case to BSG. That's it. Did nothing. You're a streamer too, muted? Yeah, well, the guy actually, like, shouted out specifically my Twitch page. I had a whole bunch of follows coming through today at just random times because of it. Raids is good, Dueno. If I complain about my raids today, Crit will never speak to me again.
Yes, Knyep.
Yeah, hello, bro. Don't fucking yes, Knyep me. Fool. Disgusting Reddit user. Yeah, exactly. Oh, look, there's things. Take this. What else we got? Any other stuffs? Have a look for another LEDX, chat. Two LEDXs in that box. No. Oh, really, Beardy? Yeah, laptops they just suck that shit in, dude. Sitting on your lap and just, yeah, they're not ideal when it comes to thermals at all. I tell you who I did have a really weird follow from the other day, though. Well, this month, anyway. On Twitter. So, premium Gamba streaming site, kick.com, follows me on Twitter. They follow less than 100 people. Why they follow me, I have no idea. Buttspot just says fuck lots and puts fuck words in your thing. See, the fins for the Heath Spray fuck had fuck as fucky the most dust I've ever seen in my life. See? Good work, Buttspot. Buttspot is a fuck whistle, indeed. Indeed. Good bot. I'm a fan of Buttspot. I really am. There's been quite a few screenshots recently that have been very good. See? Aw, cute. Yeah, Sukai, yes and no. Some of the areas of it, terrible. Terrible. Drunken, hello, mate. Butt spot, no. Don't tell, no. Come on. Blacklisted little fuckhead the moment I saw him. Oh, no. Give me a GPU. Please. No. We need cords, though. That's good. We need that. We need that. We need that. Win. Stuffs. Ugh. Yes, hello, cuz. Anything else? No. Okay. 4 minutes. We'll go check the other rooms. We'll get the fuck out of here. Mmm, it did. Air fuck the food. It's true. It happened. We were there, chat. We saw it. GPU, come on. Fuck. There's gonna be no GPUs in here. These have all been pillaged. Anyone recommend what best practice my CPU and GPU on a load test if I did this correctly? It's hard to know. Oh, to put it under stress? Prime 95 for CPU and... I don't know. Prime 64? Yeah. Like, it's a laptop. It's definitely going to thermal throttle at some point if you're running Prime 95. Like, that's just without a doubt. I don't know. GPU, I don't really know stress stuff. Stress test stuff. I mean, there might be a Prime 64 as well. Been a long time since I've used. All right, let's get out of here. We've got 2 minutes. Cinebench. No, that's CPU as well, generally. CPU would be good, actually. Ada 64, there we go. 3D Mark? Yeah, 3D Mark would probably be the go for GPU. I mean, laptops never generally good for sustained thermal. Thermals are like 90 plus. Yeah, That just could be the case, though, Beardy. 90 degrees for a CPU is not bad. Provided you're not getting constant thermal throttling. And then, even then... Yeah, like, thermal throttle in a laptop is just... I don't know how you avoid that too much. Like, I think you're always going to have that to an extent. Your thermals are very nice. It depends on the laptop, of course. Well, this is a fairly useless scav run, except for maybe this guy has got all of the goods that we wanted the whole time. Who are you, sir? What do you have? You've actually got... Oh, shit. You've actually got things. A Karund! Found in raid Karund! Bop, bop, bop. Quick, a minute. Oh, fuck that. We're just going to take that with whatever it's got. Hey, bro, what's up? This guy's hiding in the extract the whole time.
How'd you go?
Yeah, good, mate. Good. How about you?
That's good. Oh, yeah, I got one thing I needed, so that's pretty pog.
Yeah, it's nice. That's what you like to see.
Have a good one, man.
You too, man. Enjoy. Oh, shit. We didn't get out of the extract quick enough. We didn't get out. The guy had so much shit. We didn't get out quick enough. No. Oh, fuck. He had heaps of shit, dude. No. Real Cowsy, what's going on, man? Ah, that sucks. Oh, well, whatever. It's fine. Let him get his shit back on insurance. MP7 rip. I know. I'm so sad about that. What ammo are you running in here? PST. Okay. Okay, we'll probably sell that. Alright, let's get rid of that. One slotter. Techies, techies, techies. I'm just gonna have to wreck my boxes here. I get head-eyed. I wonder if he did get head-eyed. Seems weird. They got exfil cam for sure, yeah. I wonder if it was by those scavs. Well, no, because that was PMC. That was a PMC that did that kill. Karun, very nice, though. We're happy with that. Oh, what a mess. On laptop over bath of ice water. True, true. I'm shattered about that. That would have been a good win for that scab run that initially started off as fairly shit. Oh, you can't even sell those. That's alright. We'll repair it then. I don't think there's anything I want to... I can just buy those? That's really not an issue? Alright, well, let's repair this and sell it. Let's put these down here as well. I don't think the PST, keep the foods, sell the clash, keep the Momex, keep the meds, I guess. I don't know, sure. Can I show you my settings real quick? Yes, I can. Give me a second. This one? You take screenshot? These are my fuckdings quick fuck. See? Good work. Oh, this should be in full screen. Not paused. Thank you. And then I'll scroll down. And then there you go. Just take a clip of that. No post effects and just roll with that. Having said that, these are exceptionally high settings. I would not be running Taki normally with these. Like, I wouldn't recommend running Taki with these settings generally. God, that's annoying. Fuck off. Has it got shit in it still? Oh my god. Very good. Oh, that's right. I had a whole nother mag case too. 231? Jesus Christ. They're just not worth anything at the moment. Every prick's fucking making them. Basically 12 to 30 FPS on any map. Oof. Yeah, okay. That's rough. Yeah, binaural's causing a few issues for some people as well, so recommend turning that one off as well. All right, I think we're pretty solid here. We got some money, good to go. Cool. Shoreline. So we got 306. We've got our one marker for this one, and we're gonna kill five more scavs. plus whatever else we had to do for the other task there. For that one. Plus, we need two MREs. Oh, you just have to obtain them. They don't have to be found in raid. Why do I always forget this? Look at that. Great. And we only need two more scabs for this. Calzy, I've done maybe 10 raids on the streets. It's pretty good. Beardy, you can try. I would try them. I would try them and see how you go. No, he's cringy. Dude, good night, mate. Enjoy your sleeps. I really enjoy it as a map. I think it's got a lot of potential. I think I'm going to really enjoy playing a lot of that end game and sort of maybe more mid game, I guess. Early wipe, I'm still pretty chill just doing it as I need to. I think I've done like two scab runs, three scab runs on there, and maybe five PMC runs on there. But I haven't really explored around it a bit. How about you, Calzy? You played a bit on there, or? You turned it on and it made streets playable, do I know? Okay. The use physical cores, I don't know. If I was worried about that option, I would probably what I would do is actually use something like Project Lasso and do it that way rather than using the inbuilt one in the game. Does it make a difference for me? I don't know. I've never tested it. The RAM cleaner, I generally wouldn't use. For me personally, I've got 32 gig of RAM. I seem to have enough there. Could it help with memory leaks and things? I don't know. Might learn Lighthouse this wipe. Okay, fair. There's no rush. It's always going to be there. It is a good map, though. There's a few early game tasks on there. Which are pretty easy to complete. But it's a lot of fun. But things that makes you stutter. That's what I think I had. And a very long time ago when I had it on, I think that was the issue. And it's just purely because it's got to load. It's suddenly got to load all this data from disk again all the time. So, yeah. If you're not easy to complete, well, within the scope of Tarkov, I suppose, Zero Darkness, Zero Dark 40, sorry. Within the scope of Tarkov, surely. Had to have a few Sherpa friends carry me through all the rogue buildings. Oh, yeah, no, that's fine. Lighthouses are a fucking pain in the ass with the rogues. If you're not used to them, it's hard. It fixed your stutters, do I know? Right. I think it's different, definitely, for different PC configurations. There you go, that one as well. Line. We do full Sherpa lobby to go Lighthouse. Yeah, it's definitely a tough map, Lighthouse. And don't be fooled, Factory is also a tough map. And so is Shoreline, and well, I suppose Interchange is pretty tough as well. Just got a 301 key on a scav spawn? Fucking Pog, hello? Very nice. But also, it's Shoreline. So, like, yay. You got Cappy at Apple? What's going on? When are you changing your name to Capelzor? What am I even doing here? Kill scavs. Yes. Kill lots of scavs. Do more kill scavs. Marker. This is the one at the resort. And 306. Okay, we need to go to resort. Okay. That's fine. We can do that. Ready? We're going to be that guy that runs past the snake in the grass again. Yeah, have you unlocked Lightkeeper? Apple's been super busy. Like, I'm even surprised Apple's got the energy to play games. Drebs! Hello, mate. Apple, you missed it earlier, but I experienced a player with 5,000 hours in the game, by the way. But yeah, we loaded into a shoreline raid earlier with an empty Mosin and no ammo. Stayed in, you know what? We had the option of just leaving or dumping our gear and disconnecting, and I didn't. I stayed in raid for the full 45 minutes. We got a gun off a scav who had previously expired. RIP. And, yeah, and we killed another scav, and it was amazing. I got 3 tasks done. It was crazy. We made it work. You're cooked. Yeah, look, it wasn't great. It wasn't a good one. I think it was a good raid, though. I think chat enjoyed it. Kind of makes me think maybe I need to be trying to zero to hero survival mode more often. Yeah, 7.2 kilometers around the map. It was actually kind of crazy. I'm selling this 3-1 key. Fuck you, Shawn. Agreed. Very much agreed. Well, we're on Singapore, guys. Let's see how spicy 3-6 is going to be. Really kinky. Look, it was one end to the other and then back again. Like, I think 2 laps of shoreline is not out of the question. Dean, how are you, mate? Yeah, I've got Singapore and OCE selected. Mainly just for quicker raid times. For the most part, it works. Chuckles, oh my god. Hello? Chuckles. Sir, how are you? How have your raids been? How is the OCE Streets main going? And are you an expert on Streets yet? And if not, why not? And Wild Koala as well. Guys, thank you very much for the raids. Hello. Lo-Fi Nuggy, what's up, man? How are you?
Hello.
Good job.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Full jumped up.
Love it.
Yeah. Oh, no.
So good. I reckon I've done, like, I think I was saying before, we've done, like, 34. Maybe 34. 5 PMC runs on there.
Enjoying your
2 scab
absolutely.
Runs.
Yeah, we're doing Streets, pure Streets to level 40.
There you go. Pure Streets to level 40.
So we've grinded quite a bit this way.
Big fan of that behavior.
The perfect way to take.
And Wild Koala, thank you as well for the raid, man. I appreciate it.
Yep. Alright, so you're going to go up on this metal staircase.
Yep.
And you're going to look straight ahead. See that little tree? There's going to be a. Wait, come here first. You need to take my gun.
The running in the cliff. Oh my god. Yeah, I appreciate that, Chuckles, a lot. I mean, you're talking to a bloke who... I think I played one of my wives, it was like 95% interchange or something like that.
Straight ahead.
I'm definitely, definitely about it.
Straight ahead. I see a boss.
Also avoiding questing for the 100th time. True.
True. Be a tower.
Am I blind? I
don't see. Just the way that's just on the other side of that tree.
Oh my god.
Right-hand side of that tree.
Chat, I think that's people pushing me.
Am I looking at it right here?
You're looking at him right there. Yeah, he's on the grenade. You just got.
There's chats here. Candy, hello. Couldn't hear in the clip, and there was act up. They're below me, right? Yep, 100% Apple, 100% Sequel Part 1 enjoys. Do we go on the roof and blast them now? No, we let them leave. Oh no, now they're coming in here. My gun was on single, fuck! My gun was on single, no! Shit, I put like one fucking bullet into that guy and then he was just like, what? Ah, god damn it, we killed one of them too. Shit. That was an easy kill. They had no fucking clue where I was. Oh. Seriously, I'm like a rookie at this game tonight. I don't understand. Lion, they had no fucking clue, did they? Holy shit. Alright. Let's try it again, huh? Brain cooked by Melbourne weather confirmed. Some better recoil reduction here, guys. What are we gonna put on here? That one will do. And that'll do. Done. Actually, we want to save that as that. Do that. Let's grab... I don't have any rigs. Sold them all. Fuck. Let's buy a
Oh, I probably had rigs in insurance too. That's ridiculous. I did. I had a rig in insurance. Fuck. Oh, well, actually, we'll grab a bag out of there then. Done. Bit of that one, bit of that one. We need some food. That's exactly it, Dusty's dude. That's exactly it. I would not have done well as a Sherpa. Oh, you know what? We can just drink this juice there. That'll do it. Okay, let's grab some meds. Hello, medicals? One of them. One of them. We got splints down there. We're good. Go in there. Do we take a grenade? Sure. Okay. I think we're all good. Yuck. Let's try again. We get balaclava for the raid. No! Fuck, that is so annoying. I reckon I missed out on so many kills last wipe just purely because of that. Yeah, remembers ammo, forgets fire mode, Sunchaser. So look, when I get in, when I load in, we're gonna swap the fucking full auto. We're just gonna do it. I haven't actually, this is the... This would be like the third... This would be the fourth gun I've bought. This is the fourth gun I've bought, chat. Since my first day of wipe over a week ago. Everything else has just been getting returned from insurance, or I've been mosening, so I haven't had to worry about fire rate. I have ammo, backpack, rig, armor, yes, and an actual gun, confirmed. It's all there. All there on my man's. He has the things, thankfully. Hello, are we back? Not first day, just fucking NVIDIA broadcast has just been crashing recently. I think since a recent GPU driver update, I don't know. It just crashes. And it just stops my mic, because that's what I'm using for the noise cancellation. And then it just goes, hey, you know what? And just kills it. Why do you use it? Because the noise cancellation is really good. And then I can use that for, I've put the new update on. drunk, and I did that before stream. Freddy, how are you, man? So I use it as well because it's noise cancellation for VoIP in-game. Just everything, basically. Is there always a reason you go loud as a solo? I go loud on this AKM because... mainly for the recoil reduction. Mainly for the recoil reduction. I could go suppressed, but it's, like, worse ergos. And, yeah. Honestly, I figure people are just hearing me anyway. If I'm creeping around, they're hearing me. If I'm sprinting, they're hearing me. In the case of those two guys before, I don't know, man. I guess they heard me and they just didn't fucking know. If you go loud, it can save you a bunch of running. That's true. That's real true. Thank you, Sakai. I will. Yeah, I don't know. Suppressed would be better. Balky, how are you, man? What's going on? Yeah, suppressed would be better. Probably playing solo. I get that, being a little bit more stealthy and not drawing too much attention to myself. But there's also something to be said for being a bit loud and aggressive sometimes as well, in that sometimes people just fuck off from that. I'm also happy to just have a fight with people too. For the most part. Alright, load in, gun on auto. Load in, gun on auto. Make sure there's a mag in the gun. Load in, gun on auto. Ready? B. Hit B as soon as we get in. B chat. There we go. And I never use the big scopes. Wow. I mean, lots of criticism of my gameplay tonight. Jeez, tough crowd. I later wipe, I'll start using bigger scopes. But I'm not a fan of the TAC 30 as it is anyway. Of course, it's good, it's fine. I'm only messing. TAC 30, I'm not a fan of on a good day anyway. I'm a Voodoo or Razor enjoyer, typically a Razor enjoyer. And if I'm being really honest, I don't like the peripheral cut sometimes. Like, I much prefer Iron Sight or Short Optics. Because they're still good up to 150 meters. Yes, a zoomed optic, obviously better. But, yeah, I don't know. I think unless I'm actively doing something or looking for longer kills or sniping, I generally will be just a red dot of some sort or a holo. Your go-to for the TAC 30? Yeah, like, they're not bad. I know a lot of people enjoy them. I'm just not so much of a fan of the TAC 30s. It's a stash. There you are. Let's loot it out in the open so we die in a second. Hose, nice. Battery, nice. A car battery still worth stonks, chat? Are they like 100k or... Oh, fuck. Barbed wire. Are they 100k or are they 60k? Thank you, Candy. I appreciate it. Need shitloads for hideout. I think I've already done all the hideout stuff with them. I'm not sure. I don't know. Maybe I need more. I'm happy to buy them later. I'm 40 helos now. I don't know that I want to start my raid with 40 helos. Like, I could hide it in a bush and find it later. Devu, how are you, man? What's going on? Yeah, XPS 3 is I'm a huge fan of that. And if you have a little bit of sharpness set in game and you play on like a 1440 monitor or greater, like spotting people at a further distance is significantly easier. Alcans? A few people run the Alcans. They're not bad. It's just I'm not a very technically proficient player. As far as mouse and keyboard FPS gamer goes, I wouldn't say that I have a significant amount of skill. I do okay. I get by. We get done the things that we need to get done. Okay. But I'm certainly not like a god gamer as far as that goes. So when I have like I can barely remember to put my gun on full auto. Okay. 76k for battery. Okay, it's going in a bush. Maybe we get it later. Maybe we don't. Bush off the main path here, chat, up to the top. Remember that and we'll get it. My big issue is if I've got a scope that I can change zoom on and I'm trying to, like, fight people, often what happens is I just fat finger shit and I change scope to big zoomy when I don't want to be big zoomy, or I'm not big zoomy when I'm, you know, like... If I remove that option entirely, there's less chance of me fucking shit up. Streets I get anywhere between about 80 to 120 FPS. A little bit less while I'm streaming, though. That's your logic as well? Yeah. Like, I'm a old boomer gamer. I've got all that stuff on the side of my mouse too, Squid. It's too many buttons. I don't know. You youngins might not understand, but I'm... Up until 2018, for multiplayer games, I was exclusively... What do we have to mark here? What's the fucking thing that we're marking? Is it the body? Or it's these fucking med things over here, isn't it? Do I have to mark this again? Yeah, thanks. I hate it. Alright. Let's fucking get out of the way here. Tarkov's the only game you use side buttons for? Yeah. I used to use them in PUBG as well, though. But yeah, since, like, 2018 was when I first actually got a decent PC and was like, hey, I can play, like, multiplayer games. As far as a gaming PC goes. Yeah, I was exclusively controller. Like, to the point, Calzy, that when I got my PC, like, when I built a decent PC for gaming... i7 8700K, got a 1080 Ti. I set that fucker up on the TV in the lounge room. Okay. The big 50-inch. And I played PUBG on PC with a controller for easily the first 250 hours. And get this. Get this. On speakers. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It. I wish I was joking. I wish I was joking. I've got the clips to prove it. Like, don't get me wrong. I played plenty of, like, mouse and keyboard FPS games before. You know, like Half-Life or, things like that. But yeah, anything else, man. Like, any competitive FPS games. No, didn't touch them. Or, I played him on console. On the couch. With speakers. With a control. And I wasn't very good at him. I'm still not. I reckon, since that guy's busy over there, we can just rush in 306, do what we need to do, and get the fuck out again. That man's busy looting up a storm. You know, like, I just, like, I thought he was busy. Clearly he wasn't. Clearly he was just ready. Okay. And there we go. Head eyes. Very nice. Out of nowhere. Wrong. Damn, son, fucking PS Moses. Shit. Tarkov so hard after being accustomed to aim assist on COD. I don't blame that at all. I don't blame you at all for that. It's definitely hard. Oh really, Sun Chaser? Yeah, fucking ads. That's true, Drunken. I did do that. Yeah, I did. Yerp. Yeah, no, it was a different time back then. It really, like, it's, you know, it was a very different time. I mean, that was back early days of DayZ 2 though, Drunken. That was not a good time for DayZ as far as that went. But yeah, I don't know. LCW raids have been good, man. That was, yeah, that was probably the most disappointing raid I've had all night, just then. Dying after I said, hey, this won't be an issue. Oh, although I think I've completed that task now, so I think we can hand that in after this scav run. This will be my last raid, I think, for the night though, guys, too. It's 2:10. I got a bit of stuff to get. I got work to do in the morning. Got a baby shower on tomorrow as well. Meetings in the afternoon, time with the family, all that sort of stuff. I don't want to be trying to sleep in heaps and being a zombie in the morning, so I don't really get that luxury anymore. There's noise and things happening early in my house. Always, every day. Baby shower funsies, exactly. Parent life, that's it, Candy. That's it. Wouldn't trade it for the world, but also, you know, sleeping every now and then is not bad. I get more of a sleep in on my work days than any other days. Because Caitlin takes young Chase, and she leaves early for work in the morning, and takes him to daycare, and then I get to sleep in a bit. It's nice. Of course, man, of course. No worries at all, Mugen. Cyan, I am based in Victoria. Victoria, Melbourne. Outside of Melbourne, out in the eastern suburbs somewhere. 206, USEC 2. I don't think USEC 2 is worth that much, surely. Surely. Seems like a good time to stop as well, because I think we've hit that little bit of a memory leak in Tarkov, so we're a little bit frame lossy. No worries, Drunken. Dude, have a good sleep. I'll catch you soon. Them safes have been good to you? Oh, no doubt. No doubt. But I don't think it's a very expensive key, right? Like, it's not like 300k key, 400k key. I will, mate. I will catch you then. $59k? Perfect. Perfect. If it was like a 300k key, well, I'd hope we're going to the same shower, yes. I'd hope we were. Because if you go on to a different one, I think it's a little bit rude, you know? What's going on here? Who's doing this shooting? Oh, he's up the other end. Thank you. Oh my god, what is this fight? I tried to rush him with a knife. I didn't get it out in time. That's all right. GG's. Holy crap. What a fucking fight, though. Dude, he had a shotgun. Like, bro, what are you doing? That was easy kills. Oh, my God. Ugh, fuck. He was fucked. He was absolutely fucked. If I had anything that penned armor then, he was so dead. Whatever. GG's. GG's to that guy. Guys, thank you very much for watching tonight. I appreciate it. I hope you've enjoyed the stream. Thank you for hanging out with me tonight. Thank you for all the raids as well. It's been good. If it's your first time in the stream and you enjoyed the stream, follow. If you didn't enjoy the stream, I don't know why you're still here, but I appreciate the company. I should be back tomorrow night. Should do some more raids, so we'll see you then. If not, I'll be back early next week, but yeah, we'll be around. Guys, enjoy your night. Thanks for hanging. We'll find somebody to raid now too. Chat, it is popular female streamer from the OCE region train. Go and check her out. She's on ET at the moment. MP7 Gaming. Big fan of that kind of behavior, all right? Big fan of that behavior. But yeah, have a great night, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it, as always. And yeah, may your raids be fantastic until we speak again. Thanks, guys.
Hope he's not right.